So our next question basically is your last chapter, and it was a summary of the nuggets you'd like to pass on to parents. Yeah, give us three.
Number one, we should invest in the children, not invest for the children. Yes. If you invest in the child, you empower them wherever they go, they are going to excel. Because remember, in the moment you give birth to them, you're raising them to be outside your net, outside your nest. So wherever they should be able to be good team players, good parents, good, you know, good spouses, wherever they be, because you have raised them for that time. That's why it's important that children do housework at home. It's important that they do their schoolwork well, because if they're not concentrating and grasping the subject matter, it will be they've glossed over, but they'll find problems later in life when they can't apply the subject matter. So it's important that you invest in them, take them places, you know, take them to travel with them. If you travel with them, it's an opportunity for you as a parent to introduce them to concepts first time. And you know, the more you travel with them, the more their eyes are opened, and the more your eyes are opened. You know, you discover life together. And in that way, you're empowering them. So invest in the children. Don't invest for them. It's good to also invest for them, you know, to have some fallback financial position and all that's important. I don't underplay it. It's very important. But know that what you put in the child, they can never steal away. So even when they stay, go and live up country, they don't live with you. They will have the qualities you've ingrained in them. So it's important to invest for the children and not for the in the children and not just for the children. The second nugget is that in parenting, we are raising tomorrow's parents. So we should deliberately raise our children. This statement I learned from Dr. Stephen Mokowe. There's a parenting seminar I was doing with some friends of mine. And they were teaching us that, you know, we are raising tomorrow's parents. So if you are raising broken children now, they're going to be broken parents tomorrow. If they have not learned how to parent because you didn't spend time teaching them things, how will they pass that on to their children? What legacy are you as a parent leaving behind? In the Bible, there's a book, there's a story of a guy called Eli, the chief priest. You know, he was a chief priest and he loved God, but his children were sinning before God. You know, they were conning the women at the altar and all those things. And the dad says that, guys, I've heard what you're doing around, you know, stop it. But the children didn't listen. So God says, I've cut your tribe off early. I'm going to kill you guys. You know, it's going to end with you. But can you imagine the impact of that priest in his old age? You find that there are many parents in our parents' generation, guys and who are in their 70s and 80s, and their greatest regret is their children, you know? He's very wealthy, he has it all, but his children are breaking his heart. His children are disappointment. They are struggling with drugs, with alcohol, with so many things. They can't work, they can't hold jobs. They are, you know, they're just a mess. And you tell yourself, if he had spent time parenting these children, you know, he has now all this wealth that is going to be put to waste, because probably, some of these guys, the children are out there saying that, guy, when are you going? We need to sell the property off. Yet they should be working for their own property because God has empowered them. But it is an issue of intentionally parenting children. So let us deliberately parent our children. So that in our old age, we are not like the chief priest Eli, or we are not like these parents whose children are really broken, because the parents were busy chasing wealth and the world, and they did not deliberately empower their children. Now, my third nugget is that let us not forget ourselves in the process. I had a friend who was telling me that her mother gave birth to 9 of them. And the mother was regretting, saying her greatest regret is that she had 9 children. So it made me wonder that the mother maybe thought that these her daughters and sons would help her when she grows old. But that should not be our target. So even as you deliberately raise your children, you should not forget yourself. As a working mother, you know, you should keep working. You should, even if you're not working at full mast, you know, your best, you should balance both, because at the end of the day, you'll have nothing left and you have nothing and your children will be excellent. I always give this example of musical chairs, you know, that game of musical chairs where people are singing, you know, there's a song being played and the chair is moved every time. You find that mothers, because they are mothering and doing all these things, they forget and people are playing music, you know. And at the end of the day, there will be no chair for the mother because everyone else is striving to get excellent, to grow their career, grow their what, and the mother is left behind. So for me, I believe you must balance both. You must not forget your wealth. And then I also want to compare two curves. There's the curve of the mother and the father. So as you're growing, the curve is going up for both of you. The mother is growing, the father is growing. When you've just started out, the two of you married, Then you get children, the curve is growing. Then the mother stagnates because their children then starts dipping. Meanwhile, the father is going father. The older he's getting, more marketable, more jobs, more money. But the mother, you're dipping because you're babysitting, breastfeeding, all those things that come with motherhood. So what happens? The mothers forget themselves and they bury themselves into nurturing this whole family, husband, child, home, but they forget their careers. Now, much later when the children are gone, emptiness, the husband is flourishing up there, the mother is left, you know, just like that. So for me, I believe as a mother, never forget yourself. Even as everyone is going for a musical chair, even as daddy's career is growing, your career must go too. So you must be intentional in keeping your career good and must be intentional in ensuring that the career of the children and daddy, so everyone's career must be going up and should not be left behind.
Wow, you have a lot of wisdom that you are imparting in us right now. And I particularly have been thinking about the stay-home moms. The stay-home moms, I wish I could just reach out and hug you if you're a stay-home mom. Thanks for the good job you're doing. And it's just an encouragement that you're doing a great job for the future. Also, just to caution you, don't forget yourself. Don't forget yourself because you don't want to be an angry and bitter mother in the future. But even for the rest of us who are working, let's balance. Balance and have the children well taken care of, but balance also and have ourselves taken care of. So we should not forget about that. We also want to particularly, you know, think about the single mothers who don't have the fathers to model out anything to them. But those who have to model out both to the girls and to the boys, this is how life is supposed to be done. Yeah, it cannot be easy balancing everything and being there for your children and also providing food on the plate for them at the same time. It can't be easy. And I really commend single mothers out there.